Next, water clock. Next, sundial. Okay, so these are the three different devices used in the ancient period to measure the time. So now coming to the sand clock, how it works. So sand clock is a device is used to measure the time period. Okay, so this sand clock is having two bulb-like structures are attaching with a bulb neck, small neck. So for this neck having a small hole, so this hole is allowing the passage of the sand particles from one bulb to the another bulb. So it is having the sand related to that, means 1 hour sand clocks also are there, minutes sand clocks also are there. Okay, so these are completely attached for a supporter. So then what happened? So this, through this small hole what we arrange here, from this to completely this sand will occupy this bulb. This completely related to that 1 hour of time. So 1 hour time, how much time taken the sand particles to come to this bulb? It takes maybe 1 hour. So up to 1 hour this sand will comes and fall in this bottom bulb, is completely filled. After that, so that it becomes as empty now. Okay, so when it becomes as empty, again what we do, we invert this. So like that, this sand clock will work. So here I have a sand clock. Just observe this. So this is sand clock. You can observe here, this is sand clock. So two bulbs are arranged here. This supporters, all the supporting rods, these are for support of this bulb. We arrange this all. So these two bulbs are there. For these two bulbs, in the middle, a narrow neck is present. With the help of this neck, attachment of these two bulbs is happened. Okay, so in the middle, small hole is arranged there. So how we can measure? So now here, this bottom bulb having the sand particles. This upper bulb is not having any sand particles. Now we want to measure the time. What we will do? We can arrange the time in stopwatch so that we can note down how much time taken complete. Means how much time taken to flow of this sand particle from one bulb to the another bulb. We can consider as the time. Okay. So with the help of a stopwatch, we can arrange like this. So in the stopwatch, I want to arrange the time for zero. So then I am going to start the time. So now what we want to do? We want to invert like this. So we will check how much time taken to fall this complete sand from upper bulb to the lower bulb. Okay. So you also observe the time. So this sand clock. So we can observe here sand clock and we can note down the time also. In ancient periods, they used this sand clocks more, but because there is no clocks in that period, so that's why they used this type of clocks for measurement of the time. Okay, so here you can see here, so it is taking some time. Okay, so we need to observe this time. So 1 hour, 1 minute completed, 1 minute completed there.
That
size of the sample particle and the size of the neck hole. Okay, so like that it depends. Sample clock also depends upon these three factors. At the same time, this sundial have a drawback. What is the drawback of this sundial is? Okay, so this sundial works only in the daytime, especially if it is a cloudy. It will not work cloudy. Even though it is day, if it is cloudy atmosphere, upper in the atmosphere, so it will not work. Okay, so these three types of clocks are used in ancient periods for the measurement of time. Next, coming to the some modern timekeepers. Modern timekeepers. So these modern timekeepers, nowadays we are having different types of clocks. Generally, what type of clock we have? So like this wall clocks we have. So with the time, yes or no? So we are using these clocks for the measurement of time. We will use this measurement of time. In this, we are observing three hands for this. Yes or no? So one is related to the hours, one is related to the minutes, one is related to the seconds, means seconds hands, hours hands, and minutes hands. Three hands are present in this. By the rotation of this works based upon the which type of motion? Periodic motion. What type of motion we will observe in clocks? Periodic motion. What is meant by periodic motion? If a body repeats its motion after regular interval of time is called as periodic motion. We'll observe periodic motion in the case of clocks. Okay, so nowadays we are having different types of clocks. Okay, so some timekeepers, digital clocks we have. Okay, in that mechanical vibrations are converting into digital signals. Okay, there in the digital signals means we will get, for example, stopwatch. When you take this stopwatch, we will get this time in the form of digital numbers we are observing. So how we are observing there? What happened? The mechanical waves are converting. The mechanical energy we are getting. So these mechanical vibrations are converting into digital signals so that we can get that digital forms. Not only that, in cooking utensils, if you see that some induction stoves and some microwaves. Okay, so if you see some cookers, pressure cookers are there. Okay, so these are time. Based upon the timekeepers, they are arranging in that. So there also we need to measure the time. These are nowadays what we are using, different types of the clocks. And these clocks are also called as quartz clocks. Quartz clocks. So this type of clocks are called as the quartz.